Why do we need ADC? And what is ADC? I have already written analog to digital converter. ADC means analog to digital converter. Okay. Analog to digital converter. Yes? Okay. Why do we need ADC? Don't say to convert analog to digital. So all the processes that we have, are they analog or digital?
Digital.
They are digital. That means none of the processes directly understand the analog data. That means any signal that you are giving as an input cannot be directly understood by the system, or we can say as a processor. That is why every processor needs an analog to digital converter first, so that the analog data can be converted to digital, and then the output that can be given as the input to the processor for the processing of the data. Correct. So do we have in our controller in Atmega 328P, do we have inbuilt analog, I mean inbuilt ADC do we have, or do we have to connect it externally? We have one internal ADC. That means we have an inbuilt ADC here. Correct? Inbuilt ADC. How many ADCs are there inbuilt? One ADC. Okay? So now let's try to understand about that ADC. How many input channels it has? Input channels.
8 channels.
Yes?
8 channels.
6 channels. Okay. So let's go to the manual and understand.
8 channels.
8 channels. So let's go to the manual and understand. Let the manual open. Pins are 6, but it has 8. To this port connector. Okay, let it open. Until then, we'll understand few things. What all registers you have come across yesterday in the yesterday session? Registers are explained, right? What all are the registers? You have AD marks, then AD R. AD SR A. I mean AD SR. This is not there. I will open the PPT.
ADCH.
AD, one minute. Tell me. ADCH. Then.
ADCSRA.
ADCSRA.
ADLAR.
ADLAR
and ADCH.
ADCH athlete.
Yeah, ADC SRB.
SRB, okay.
DIDR.
So AD marks. So that is what is the first one, AD marks. Then AD marks. Scalar. ADC SRA. So that's what is written, SRA. Then ADC SRB. So ADC SRB we have written. And here it is DIDR, correct? Yes. So DIDR. What is this ADLAR? H? Let's come. So now let's come to the ADC here. So how many input channels are there to the ADC? So check here what it says. It is a 8-channel analog multiplexer. That means it has 8 input channels. And it says it is a 10-bit successive approximation ADC. That means what will be the resolution of the ADC? 2 power 10. So 2 power 10 is 1024. But it is going to start from 0. That is why 0 to 1023 can be the maximum bit value that you can get here. Correct? Okay, so let's make a note of that. So about this, it is a 8-channel ADC. Okay, then 10-bit ADC. Understand, 8-channel ADC. When I'm saying channel, that means it is a number of input channels, correct? And if I say 10-bit ADC, that means output is going to be 10-bit. Always. Yes? So if I say it is 8-bit ADC, what does that mean? Output of that ADC is 8 bits. So how much ever bit we specify here for any of the ADC, that indicates the output of that. So if I say it is 12-bit ADC, what does that mean? Output of that ADC is 12 bits, 2 power 12, 4096, like that. Okay. So because of this, because it is a 10-bit ADC, resolution of ADC will be 2 power 10. I'll write like this, 2 power 10, which is 1024. So numbers will be 1024 to 1023. Done. That we have to know about the ADC. Let's see. Okay, here itself you will get so many features of the ADC, correct? Out of which one you will have to see how many bit ADC, second you have to take in mind how many input channels it has. Yes?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes?
Ma'am, screen is not displaying, madam.
So no one screen is displaying?
Yeah. Now okay, ma'am.
Now?
Now okay, ma'am.
Now? Notepad is visible. Notepad.
Yes, ma'am. It's visible.
Fine. Okay. So now how is the ADC going to work? Do you know how many control pins ADC has? Is it explained or not? Control pins of ADC. Or what will be the flow of ADC? How we are going to program it? Not explained. So let's put up a diagram to understand this, how to work with the ADC. This is your analog to digital. Yes, analog to digital converter. So what it has, it needs an input. That means first and foremost thing when you are working with the ADC will be you have to select an input channel. Yes, so you will have to select an input channel for this. So I'll just write. First thing is the input channel to be selected, and you have an option of selecting the V reference also. Yes, reference voltage, internal reference voltage. So what is that? So one thing is you have to select the input channel, and another thing is the V reference. So let me write it. So first point is input channel. And second point is V reference. Correct. Now, how is the ADC going to start or how it is going to work is, by default, if you have seen in the resistors, by default ADC is enabled or disabled. That means as soon as you power up your controller, will the ADC start working? No. That means by default it is disabled. In the resistors, again I will show it to you. So that means once you select the V reference, then you have to first start, that means enable the ADC, not the conversion. You have to enable the ADC as well. So even that you need to take care here. That means something like, it's not an order, I'm just saying what all you have to do. Enabling of ADC, because by default it is disabled. Yes. So once you make sure that ADC is enabled, that means you can start. That means you can, as soon as you give the input, based on whatever voltage it is going to receive, it is going to give us the sampled output. Correct. So what you have to do, you have to indicate to the ADC, start the conversion. Yes. So once the conversion is started, how do you get to know that conversion is complete? That means if it is receiving 4.2 volts. Yes. So 4.2 volt in a sampled way, how do I get to know that the conversion is complete or not? Yes. How to get to know? I know that it started the conversion. That means I should know now that when is the conversion going to end? Yes. So for that, you will have to concentrate on some flag here. And in which resistor it is, again I'll explain it to you. So you will have to wait for that flag. Then you can read the output of the ADC. So that means here you have to wait first until the conversion is complete. So somewhere like this point, wait for the conversion to complete. That is your fifth one. I mean, as an what all you have to do, I'm just saying. Now, once you get to know that conversion is complete, what you can do? Conversion is completed, you just have to read the output, correct? So last step will be read the converted value. This is going to be the last step, nothing else. So these two, I mean, simple steps we will have to follow in order to program a particular ADC. So to do all of this, first we need to get to know about the resistors that are involved in the ADC, correct? So where are the resistors now? How do we get the information? We have the manual data sheet of the controller here. So wherein we'll go ahead with seeing what all resistors are there and what all the resistor, like for what objective the resistor, which resistor you will have to configure. So let's come to the resistor part. What we can do is, you can find out the resistor directly, AD mux. So you get the resistor description here. Yes, so once you come to the register description, the first register itself is AD marks. So what it is saying? It is used to select the multiplexer. That means it is a multiplexer selection register. So we don't know, we don't understand, right? What it is saying here. For that, let's go to the bitwise description. Before going to bitwise, see how many bits it is first of all. How many bits there are? 0 to 7. That means it is a 8-bit register is what you have to understand. Okay. Now come to bit 7 and 6. 7 and 6. What it is saying? REFS1, REFS0. That means 2 bits are dedicated in order to select a reference voltage. Now how do I understand that? Look at the chart here. If it is 0, 0, means A reference, internal reference is turned off. If it is 0, 1, that means external reference at the reference pin. That means a particular VCC reference voltage, AVCC, will be selected. If it is 1, 0, that means I cannot use this combination. Giving 1, 0 has no effect. If it is 1, 1, internal 1.1 voltage reference will be given. Yes. So based on what reference we need, we have to configure 7 and 6th bit of AD mux register. So here, do we have anywhere? Yes, we have here. That means which register you will have to configure? AD mux. So for the registers, let's see some. So for this step, you have to use AD mux register. Which are the bits? 7 and 6. Yes, understood. Okay. Now let's come to some more bits there. What all bits are there? ADLAR is there. What it is saying? ADC left adjust result. That means it affects the presentation of the ADC conversion result in the ADC data register. So writing one to that to left adjust the result. So we don't want any adjustment here. So we are nowhere taking that ADLAR bit here. Okay. Then, which all bits are there? Mux 3, mux 2, mux 1, mux 0. That means we need to see now what is this 3, 2, 1 and 0 bit. Yes. So let's go to 3, 2, 1 and 0. Analog channel selection bits. We have to select analog channel as well. Which is the input channel we need to select. So which bits you are going to program here? AD mux. 3 to 0 bits you will have to program. Correct? Okay. Now, what values you will have to give in order to select a particular channel? Let's come to the bit table. See, look at the bit table. 4 bits are there, means how many values you will get? 16 values you will get. How many input channels are there? How many input channels are there? 8 input channels are there. So, if I have to select input channel 0, what is the combination? 0. If I have to select input channel 1, what is the combination? 0001. If I have to select 2, 2 is the value you have to give. 3, 3, like this, till 8, 8. Yes? Okay. Now what is this here saying? Here 1 means there is something written. This 8 you are going to take if you are connecting a sensor here. And what is that sensor you can connect? We have a temperature sensor called as LM35, which you can connect to that 8. That means that is specially meant for a temperature sensor here. Yes? No, there you will have to connect the temperature sensor. That is. There means that is already a temperature sensor. For the temperature sensor it is. That is. Channel pin. Yes? Now, if I select AD0.0, that means which will be my hardware pin? How do I get to know? See, ADC0 it is saying, ADC1 it is saying, ADC2 it is saying, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 it is saying. Now how do I get to know on the hardware? If I select ADC0, then which is the hardware pin? How to get to know? Where do you have the pinout description? We have a diagram already with us where we have a pinout description. So let's go to that diagram now to understand which is the actual hardware pin. So where in the first day I was explaining like where is LED, which are the ports like that. Yes, so that time I had said few things we'll understand later also. Correct. So now let's understand about ADC. Can you find out anywhere ADC0, ADC1 like that? On which port it is? It is on C. That means port C A0 to A5, which is port C itself, the same pins can be acting as ADC0, ADC1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where are the other two? Other two are here. Where are the other two? No, it is 5, 4 again. Other two are not there. Where above? LED is here.
No, above
there. Where? Here.
Above.
This one?
Above 13 pin.
Where it is?
Restart.
Where is your pin reset?
Here.
This. Here. But it is 4-5. 4-5 already we have here. Where is 6 and 7? On the hardware as such, you don't have 6 and 7. You don't have 6 and 7. Yes? So, whichever out of this you want analog pins, you can select. So AD0 to AD5, that means you can do till here, any of the combination you can select as an input channel. That's what that pin itself is not there. You can connect the same temperature sensor here also.
In Arduino board there is 6 pins for analog only.
Analog only, huh?
But we have 8 input.
8 input, that means 6, I mean 2 more are not available. And then you cannot use those channels, simple. That means maximum you can connect 6 analog sensors.
Then how we check reference? 8
is
now.
Okay, so see here, that means if I select ADC0, you are going to connect to A0. If I select ADC1, you are going to select, give to A1 like that. So A0 to A5 you can select. That means it is AD0 to AD5. 6 analog input channels you can find here. Online students, clear? Any doubts here?
Ma'am, show that pic again. Here also ADC5, ADC4 and AREF. And ADC5 is repeated twice now. Why?
That means this can also be used as ADC4 and 5. Its multifunctionality is like that. You can use this pin also as ADC5 and 6. I mean 4 and 5 like that. Two pins can have same function, no?
Yeah, okay.
Right. Anything else?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So let's go ahead then, where we were in the manual page. Okay. So that is about, so all the bits we have understood. Here all we have understood, here all. Then let's come to the next register. What is the register? ADC SRA. SR indicates control, C indicates control, and SR indicates status register. Now here it says A, that means there is one more register. Wherever you get one, that means there will be another. That way, if it is A, that means you need to understand there is one more register. Now, why there is one more register? Here it is A. What can be there in B? Let's try to understand. B. Yes? So, that means total control and status has to be read in both the registers. Whatever you want to do, controlling action will be some bits in A, and status and control will be some bits in B as well. That means total, instead of, because we have only 8 bit registers everywhere, so total control and status will be done by A and B together. So few bits will be there in A, few bits will be there in B like that. Okay, so first let's understand with A now. What all, how many, all the bits are there from A here? All the bits are A. Okay, before this, let me come to the default value first. So what do you understand by the initial value means? Everywhere it is zero. What does that mean? No, zero means not disable always. That means whatever function it is saying there, that function is by default. See, if both these bits are 0, 0, means what? 0, 0, that means there is no internal reference. If all these are 0, 0, means which channel is selected by default? AD0 is selected by default. That way you have to understand. That means if you don't configure this register also, by default ADC0 channel is selected only. It is a by default channel. And here by default there is no V reference taken. That way you have to understand. Okay? Is that clear?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Now, let's come to this. See, we have ADEN, SC, DAT, IF, IE, PS2, PS1, PS0. Let's come one by one. What is this first one saying? ADC enable. Writing this bit to 1 enables the ADC. What is the initial value? 0. That means by default ADC is enabled or disabled? Disabled. That means you need to definitely make this bit 1, else whatever you do with the ADC, ADC is not going to work because it is disabled by default. And have we, did we mention it somewhere? Here we have mentioned it. So which register you will use? ADC SRA, 7th bit you are going to use. I just mention it here. For enabling the ADC, which register? ADC SRA, which bit? 7th bit you are going to. Next, let's come to next bit. What is this? ADSC. ADSC means what? Come to the bit description. ADC start conversion. Now see the reset value again. It is 0. What it says? Write this bit to 1 to start the conversion. Do we have start conversion anywhere? Yes. So which register you are going to configure here? ADC SRA. Which bit? 6th bit you are going to configure. Then ADAT, what is this? This is auto trigger enable. When it is 1, auto triggering of the ADC is enabled. We are nowhere using auto triggering here, so we are not concerned with this bit. Then ADIF, read about ADIF. It is a very important bit, very much important bit. This bit will be set when the conversion is complete and the data registers are updated. That means I want to know, right, conversion is complete or not. That means you have to read this particular bit in ADSRA register. That means you have to wait until that bit goes 1. Why we are waiting until that bit is 1? Because now with the description we understood that if the conversion is complete, that flag will become itself 1. Yes, so are we anywhere waiting for the conversion to complete? Yes, we are waiting. So where are you going to do this? ADCSRA register, 4th bit you are polling. That means you are waiting for that bit to become 1. So that you get to know that conversion is complete. Correct? Then, what else it says? Alternatively, ADIF is cleared by writing a logic 1 to the flag. Now assume first time I give 4.2, conversion is complete, flag is high. Now second time I give a next input, I should know, right, conversion is complete or not. That means before going ahead with the next conversion, I should clear the flag. Then how do I clear the flag? By writing 1 to the same bit, writing 1. Reading, if you read 0, that indicates conversion is not complete. If you are able to read that it is 1, that means conversion is complete. If you write 1 to the same bit, that indicates you are clearing that particular flag, which is necessary where there is a continuous conversion. Yes, So before reading the data, the intermediate one more step you have to do here, and that is, I'll just write it as 5A. What is that? Clear the ADIR. That means you will simply pass 1 to ADC SRA register. Now come to the other bits. ADI. What is ADI? ADC interrupt enable. Anyhow, still we have not understood what are interrupts there, correct? So we are not nowhere related to that particular bit. So as of now, don't get there's no need of understanding this bit because we are not following an interrupt method. We are following a polling. Polling means we ourselves are checking for one flag if it is high or not to know that the conversion is complete or not. Okay. Then after that, there is PS2, PS1, PS0. That means these three bits are together. That we have to understand. So let's come down. What is this doing? This determines the division factor between the system clock frequency and the input clock. That means to give a prescale value, you have to select this prescalar register bits. Yes. So that means if you just give 000, the division factor between the system's clock and the input clock that the ADC is receiving will be 2. It is a by default one. See, 000 is a by default one. So here we are going to select 128 prescale. You can select anyone. It will be mentioned what prescale you have to use. Based on that, you have to select the bits PS0, PS1 and PS2 like that. So in our program, we are following 128 prescale. Okay. So when you are going to do this, when you enable the ADC here itself, you are going to give the prescale also. So let me put it as PRESCALAR, which is the register to do this prescaler. It is ADCSRA bits 220. And what is the value you are going to give? You are selecting prescale of 128. That means prescale should be 128. That means the value will be 111 according to the manual. See here, 128 means value should be 111. Now, what is this ADCH and ADCL we have to understand? ADCH and ADCL, correct? What are these? This is lower and higher data resistor, correct? Now tell me, how much will be the bit data maximum? How much will be the data maximum converted? How many bits? 10 bits? 10 bits? ADC is 10 bit ADC, right? That means result will be 10 bit only. Yes. Now, how many bit resistors we have? 8 bit resistors we have. That means where will be the other 2 bits going? That is why you have 2 resistors, L and H. L and H you are getting here. Okay. So, see here. What is ADLAR? ADLAR is that trigger, correct? Where we had come across here, ADLAR. Left adjust result and right adjust result and all that. So if it is 0 by default, that means if you don't configure this bit at all, what is the value? Otherwise the result is right adjusted. Right adjusted, left adjusted is what you understand? The bit shifting will happen. Okay. So changing the ADLR bit will affect the ADC data register. And that is what is indicated here in the down, like in the description. If it is 0, what is the result? It will be right shifted, it is saying. Correct? Yes. So what will happen? in ADCL the result will be like this, and in ADCS the result will be like this. If you make it as one, in ADCH right shift means the result will be here, in ADCL the result will be here. Yes, so to together read the result, what register you will use? Total value will be 10 bit, you know it already. So instead of taking ADCH and ADCL like that, you just simply take ADC. So to read the total value, anyhow we are printing it somewhere, so we don't have to bother where will be the shifting occurring, but you should know about it. Yes, so see here, when ADC conversion is complete, the result is found in these two resistors based on LAR. If it is 0, result is right shifted. If it is 1, result is left shifted. Yes, okay. See here, that is what is here. These bits represent the result from the conversion. That is what is together ADC. ADCH, ADCL, together with ADC only, 0 to 9 bit. That means ADC is a 10 bit register divided as ADCH and ADCL. So how many bits ADCH has, how many bits ADCL has, depends on what is ADLAR. If it is 0, ADCH only 2 bits will be there, ADCL all the 8 bits data will be occupied. If ADLAR is 1, ADCH all bits will be occupied, L will be having only 2 bits. That is. Are you understanding what I am saying here? So read the read the converted value means you have to read ADC register. How many bit value it will be? It will be a 10 bit value. Why? Your ADC is a 10 bit ADC. So simple. So that is about ADC. Next coming to this ADSRB. A we studied till now. Now let's come to B. What all it says? Anyhow, few bits are reserved here. Let's come to 6th bit. 6th bit is saying trigger source selection. Yes, so we are nowhere considering a trigger sources. That means for the ADC, our triggers we are not adding anywhere here. Simply an input, then taking the output. So that is why as a trigger sources, we are not configuring this register at all. But that register is also still there. So which all we finished? This done, this done, this done, this also done. This is a bit, not a register. Correct. Then what else is remaining? DIDR. So DIDR, what it is doing? Digital input disable register. What it says? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means read what all it is saying. When this bit is written logic 1, the digital input buffer on the ADC pin is disabled. That means that particular pins AD0, AD1, AD2, which are A0 even on the board, those you can generally use as a digital pins. Means in our any GPIO programming, you can use them directly. Why? Because see the initial value. By default, the values here are 0. That means by default, those pins are digital only. So if you want to convert it to analog, that means what you have to do? A digital input buffer on the pin is disabled. That means you have to write high on the pin to disable the digital input. That means to enable the analog input that way. Yes? Okay. See now here, what is the note saying? That means do we use these pins anywhere? Should I configure this register now? According to the first statement, whatever it is saying, I should configure, correct? See here, what it says. Note that ADC pins 7 and 6 do not have digital input buffers and therefore do not require digital input disable bits. only AD0 to AD5 pin you have to use. I mean, you have to enable and disable whenever required. So that is about that resistor. Yes. So let's sum up. What all is there in ADMUX? You have channel selection. What else you have? You have reference voltage to select in ADMUX. In SRA, we have so many things. ADC, SRB, related to auto trigger, which we are not using. In SRA, what all we have? We have pre-scaling to be done, pre-scaler, then enabling the ADC, start conversion, and checking for the flag, wait for the conversion. This is together ADC, which is read the result, and this is to enable . So how will be the steps looking like here? Let's understand the steps. First one, what should be done first and foremost before channel selection? Check the V reference. So let's put this diagram. Here we understand. Selecting the V reference. Selecting the V reference. After that, you select. To enable the ADC and the pre-scaler. How much pre-scaler I want according to me now? 128 maximum. The third one, what is left? Enabling done, this is done, this is done. Input channel we have to select. So select the input channel. Where? What is the by default input channel? Default input channel. AD0. Got 0. 0th one is the by default. Next. You have to start the conversion. Then wait, clear and read the data. So for the then clear the flag, then the data. Seven steps. C 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Something we missed. 3 here, 4 was there. Oh yeah. Here both together I have written. Together I have written. So 8 total points. Any doubts here? So we know how to program now. That means we know the steps. We know the resistors. We know which all bits also to be used. Yes? So let's try writing a program. I will just send this first to you. I'll send it later. Now tell me, how can you do the first step? I'll just say main function. Any direction setting, anything you have to do? No. Nothing to be done. I have to select the V reference. What is the resistor?
AD0.
7 and 6. I want that AV reference, correct? So what is the combination? 10. Mm-hmm. 01. Yes? So 01 means where is 0 here? 6th bit. So I should make the 6th bit 1. How to make it? sixth bit I have to make one. That means can't I use like this? Yes. First step. Next. Enable the ADC. Select the prescaler. How to enable the ADC?
7, 10, 10, 0.
Anyhow, it is 0, no? Next. Enable. How to enable the ADC? Here. According to the steps, I am saying. Enable the ADC. Select the prescaler. How to enable the ADC?
ADC
SRA 7th bit. Yes? Okay. So, ADC SRA 7th bit. And also I have to select the prescale here, 128. So, to indicate 128, it is in the same register again. Combination is 111. Which bits have to send 111? 0, 1 and 2. 111 means how much? 7? So can I shift 7 0 times? 7. I am using OR to keep the previous value also and the next value also. So this. Three ones. 1, 2, 3. Next, select the input channel. By default, it is 0. Then, what is the register to select the input channel?
Admux.
Yes? Okay. Now, what is the input channel I want to select? Whichever channel you want, you select. Now, if it is 0, then you don't have to write it there anyhow. Yes? If you don't want to write, then here, anyhow, what is the value you are giving to select this reference? 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. That means already if it is 0, 0 that you want to indicate, already it is selected. Yes? So, this step is by default done if it is AD0.0. Don't mention here again ADMUX equal to 0. No. This will get erased then. Then that time you have to indicate here OR. Are you understanding? Online students.
Yes, ma'am.
This is the one. So don't write it better. If it is the 0th bit, you want to select AD0.0. The conversion. How to start the conversion? How to start ADC SRA 6th bit. So take ADC SRA. You need the previous one also. Value 6th bit. Done. Next. Wait for the conversion to complete. In the same register, 4th bit you have to read. How do we do it? ADC SRA in this 4th bit I want. That means what I'll do, I will AND it with one left shift of 4. You know this, we used it in a switch condition to know the status. ANDed with one left shift of 0, pin B register. I said why we are ANDing it with one always. Yes? To get the switch status. Did I write while pin B ANDed with one left shift of 0 not? Like this. In the switch, I had written like this. 1 minute, I'll show it to you. Pin B. I had written for the switch. Here there was a condition I was writing, if I was writing. Here, see this. Why I am ending it with 1 shifting to 0? Because to the 0th pin, I have connected the switch. Why I am passing 1 there and ending it? If the pin B value is 0, result will be 0. If pin B value is 1, result will come 1. That means you are ending with 1 always to get the original value. So now which bit value do you want? Which bit value you want? Fourth bit value? So I am passing 1 to the fourth bit. And ending with which register? Whose fourth bit you want to know? Not equal to means until it is 0, you are in the same loop. As soon as it is 1, ADIF to be 1. You are waiting. Or ADIF to become 1. That means you are waiting for the conversion to complete. Until this and this is 0, it will be in the same loop. Yes or no? Until the flag is 0, will it not be in the same loop? Bahab is not there. So as soon as it becomes 1, 1 not with 0, condition false, it will come out. Understanding? Okay. Now clear the flag. How to clear the flag? ADC, SRA register. You should write what? How to clear the flag? You should write 1 to the same bit. Write 1. How do you write? 1. Write it. What else? Then read the data. Where is the data present now? Where is data present? In which register? ADC. That means you have to read the register. That means you take the register. Reading means what? Taking it and storing it in a variable. What kind of variable it will be? I will be integer, character, what it will be? Yes? Understanding? Okay. Now, I have to display this value somewhere. Assume it is taking complete 5 volts. What will be ADC giving as output? 1023? Maximum value. If it takes complete 5 volts, maximum value will be 1023 that it is going to show. Where should I display? Where can I display now? Any display device we have understood or no? No? LCD. That means this result you have to load on LCD now. Can you load integer on LCD? No? No, right? Can you load integer on LCD directly? No. That means, assume, if you have got an output now like 1023, this you need to convert to 1023, like this you should convert. That means you should do here int to ASCII conversion, which you know how to do in C. So instead of that, I will give you an inbuilt function. SPRINTF is the inbuilt function. So how will it look like? I'll just write it here. This is int to ASCII conversion. For that inbuilt function, SPRINTF, what will be the first value is, let me write the second value. No, 4. It has 3 arguments. Which value you know? Integer value we know or string we know? Integer we know. That means here, format specifier, you will write percentage %d. Okay, now. Which is the integer variable where the result is stored? I. So that will be the third argument. So here I'll write integer variable prototype. What will be the first one then? After converting from integer to ASCII, the result should be stored somewhere, which should be a character array. So character variable. Understanding? Now tell me, how do I use it? SPRINTF. First argument I have not yet declared. So let's declare. I'll say A. Or how much should be the size of this? 10, no. 10 bits will be the result. 10 only you give. Okay. Let's give 11 here. Because null also should come. How do I use it now? What will be the first argument? A. Second argument, percentage D, third one I. You have used S printer. In Arduino directly LCD that functions that you use, those are directly giving character only. Now result is in A. That means string converted format is in A. How do you print on LCD? How to print A, A which is having a string using for loop? Yes or no? So I'll say k equal to 0, a of k not equal to null k plus plus. Correct? That a of k. This should be a data function. So that means you should include both the functions of LCD here. So can you directly operate LCD like this? No. You need the commands of LCD first. So you need to include command also here. What is the first one? Let's operate LCD in 8-bit mode only. That will be easy. 0x01, then 0x0B, right here B. Done. So once pre-scale is done and your conversion is started, this I'll put it in a while loop from here so that continuously the conversion and everything, let it happen. And data one
command one command first two one data after the
zero
after one.
Anyhow, you can give any order. All these are to initialize the LCD. Yes? So then you started this and this. That means what is this doing? It's a V reference. Here it is enabling, here it is pre-scale. So starting the conversion, this I'm just going to put it in a loop right now. So that conversion will be continuous. That means even if you try to vary the voltage, that value should get reflected. Yes? So after this, how many? 1, 2, 3, one more I have to do. So after displaying, I will just clear the LCD so that continuous display you can get. Is this understood? Online students, any doubts here?
No, ma'am.
No. So this file I'll share it to you. Now let's understand how to do it in Proteus. So to do on Proteus, to display LCD is there and Arduino board is there. So let's connect LCD in 8-bit mode now. Okay. So how to connect? For LCD connection in 8-bit mode, I have taken RS. The previous program that we have written, the same I am talking about. So RS is this, port B0, enable is port B1, all the 8 pins are on port D. LCD in 8-bit mode you operate. Yes, what should happen with RW? It should be connected to ground.
Ground.
Yeah. Now where is ADC input channel? Which one did I select in my program? 0. What should I do with ADC 0? What should I do here? What should I connect? What should you connect? If you connect to ground, that means analog pin will be 0. So the conversion will be 0 only. What should I connect? You should connect a varying voltage there. That means you should connect a pot. Potentiometer you should connect, which will give a varying voltage. So now if I connect this 0, output will display as 0 only. If I connect 5 volts there, I can connect a power supply here. How much will it display on the LCD? 1023. Correct? So I will show it to you first connecting 5 volts. So let's connect 5 volts. 5 volts connected. Yes, so let me just dump the program. Have you written the program? No. It's not written. So I just write it. So I have a program with me already. The same what I have shown, I have written here. So let me just put it here. Here ADC is in 4 bit mode, so I have to convert 8 bit. Let me convert 8 bit. Out of this, I will take only the functions, 8-bit functions. So, you know already how to operate ADC in 8-bit, LCD in 8-bit mode, correct? So I'm just directly loading the program here. Here I will make 3A. Here for LCD I am using data pins port D, so I have to be better. And here it can be 03 only because only 2 pins I am using. So first what will happen? You selected the reference. See there whatever program I have written, there I have used the bit number. Here what I am showing, it is only the name of symbol that they have used. So this will get confused, so I have written the bit numbers. Both you can use. Whatever symbol comes in the register, same is shown here. You can use bit number or the symbol also, both will do. Okay. So enabling, selecting the prescale. Then here whatever rest of the part, that is selecting the channel, then starting the conversion, waiting for the conversion, clearing the flag and reading the data, that I have just taken it as one function called as here. I have made it as a function, nothing else, no change. Channel selection, start conversion, waiting for the flag, then here clearing the flag, returning that ADC value. This value is written, which are collected as an integer here. Here I have collected, nothing else. Rest all is same. Then converted the result, loaded on LCD, clearing the LCD, I have put it in a while loop, simple. Is that clear? Online students, no change in the program, same program. The few lines are made as one function and called that function. Okay, so I'll just compile. So let's export this. Just a minute, it's very slow. So see how much it is showing? 1023 it is showing. Why? Because I have connected here 5 volts completely. Yes. Now if I have to connect the pot here, potentiometer, what should I do? I should still connect it here only. So let's try to understand how do we connect a potentiometer wherein we can give a varying voltage. So I'll just click here, go to component mode, give here pot only. So you will get here pot active. So take this. Click on OK. Place it here. So see how does it look like? You just have to delete it. Now it has three things, correct? Three terminals. This should be connected to varying voltage, that how it is going to receive. Another end connected to ground. This should be connected to your input. Yes, so let me connect this first. Input. And this should be connected to ground. So let me just connect to ground. Then I have to connect a varying voltage here, generator. So let's take generator. Which kind? I want a DC kind. Yes, DC kind. So let's give a DC one here and connect it here. Done. Okay, now let's run it. Before running, voltage I have to specify here. Voltage I have to specify. Give how much ever voltage. We are working with 5, so I have given 5 volts. Done. Okay. Now check. I will just start again. How much it is taking? Half the way it is taking. Even if I give 5 volts, why half the way it is taking?
What? It's a resistor value or medium.
So here, whatever value you are giving, it is dropped inside. Yes? So you just start changing. So here if you can see, there is a plus, and here if you see, there is a minus. This is only to vary the pot. See the arrow where it is. It is exactly in between. That means how much it is taking? 5 volts. In that half it is taking. That is why you are getting 512. Half of 1024. Yes. Now observe. If I just increase here, as of now it is showing 512. I will increase. See where this arrow will go. Check. Is it not going up? It's going up. Now it is half the way. Now once I click on 1, see the value 614. Next I click 717. Next 819. Next final one 912, 22, and the last one 1023. Correct. Now let's come down. Check here, it has reached maximum. Next. Half the way we had gone already. Now let me decrease it. Decrease less than 512. Decrease 37. 25. 102. 1. Now why it is not showing 0? It should stop for 0, 0 only.
Inbuilt minimum resistance.
Yeah, here you cannot actually throw as a zero. I mean, minimum you cannot throw here as zero, because how much ever you are giving, it is dropping here. That is why minimum you will get one only, not less than that. Zero you won't get here. Okay, is that clear, everyone? Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
On others, any doubts?
No, ma'am.
So here we connected the varying voltage now. Yes, that means varying time. I mean, analog voltage we connected 0, 1, 2. It is just taking however it is. I mean, it is dividing and taking it. Correct. Now, what if I connect a sensor? Which kind of sensor I have to connect? Analog sensor I have to connect. And analog sensor, if you want to try, online students also, you can connect a temperature sensor here. Name of the temperature sensor is LM35. If you connect the input LM35, output will be voltage or Celsius here to the conversion. Voltage only. That means if you want to know the exact degree, how much is the temperature it is sensing, you need to make some conversion there. Voltage to degree conversion. Okay, so question can be asked like, read a sensor value and do this particular operation that way. That means you need to understand. Sensor value means definitely temperature sensor. That means you should take an ADC first. Include ADC. So if the temperature value is this much, then what you have to do? Run a stepper motor. So you know how to work with ADC separately. You know how to work with temperature sensor. Both will be combined and question will be asked that way. Just an example I give. Is it clear? Online students, clear?
Yes,
sir. So today what you will be doing is, whatever program I have written, I am going to share it to you. So you just have to write the program and check the simulation on the Proteus. And if time is there, because it is already 1:03, still if the time remains till before by 1:30, you can try for temperature sensor. Else anyhow in the extra lab you can do it. Has everyone finished with the motors day before yesterday? Motors?
No, no, I'm not done now.
When will you do, Prashant?
My laptop is not working, that's why I got the video.
Today is it not working? Today?
No, ma'am, from 2 days it's not working.
Okay, how about others? If you do not say that you have done or no, I will assume it that you have done and I'll go ahead.
No, ma'am.
Today we will try, ma'am.
So now, as of now, till 1:30, you finish ADC first.
Okay, madam.
Any other time, afternoon, you are free or no?
Afternoon, we are free, ma'am.
Then that time you can finish motor, everyone.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Okay. So I'll be sharing the file. You can go through it and work on ADC now. Okay. And one more thing. So tomorrow will be the next theory class. That will be on timers. Okay. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be sending you a link of a video that you have to go through today itself. Maybe in the evening you can go through. When I get the link, I'm going to share it to you guys. You have to go through it and then come for the class tomorrow at 11:30. Timer's concept is there. So you have to go through that video first and then come to the class. Okay? Yes? Wherein after listening to video, you will get many doubts. That will be cleared in tomorrow's class, and just once everything will be revised on timers. Yes? So as once I share the link before coming to tomorrow's class at 11:30, you need to go through and then come to the class. Topic is thymus. Okay. Okay. Fine. I'll end the meeting then. Work on ADC, and if you get any doubt, you can ask me in WhatsApp.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.